to call.
Good morning, or good afternoon, I should say, everyone. Today is the March 10th meeting for the Health Committee. We have a quorum. I'm going to get right to it, but before that, since we are the Health Committee, it would be remiss if we didn't talk about, just for a second, about what's happening right now with Corona. Let's make sure there's two basic things that we should keep at the top of our heads. Number one, let's not panic. Number two, let's not be racist, since we know that there were some cases originally that came from, that were found in China. That means that some folks feel that that's probably where they should put their ire, and I know that has had an impact on some businesses all across the state, as well as some instances of hate crimes that have occurred. So I would encourage everyone to be not racist. It seems like that's something that we should always strive not to be. And then some basic safety procedures that everybody should have. I know that I've started moving to the fist bump or the elbow bump is what you should probably do as well to minimize physical contact. As well as washing your hands for those 20 seconds. That is always important. Realize, by the way, that the hand sanitizer, although useful, does not actually kill the virus. So does not kill the virus. It kills other things that might spread disease. So wash that hand for 20 to 20 seconds. And also, we should be wary about places where there are a lot of folks at the same time. Kind of like here, but not really. We're not hugging each other, what have you. So as long as we do those things, we keep demanding that the federal government move up its testing regimen, which is really the issue here. We have not tested enough people quickly enough. We know that there are more cases than the ones that have been found. That is just factual, but we have not been able to test all of them because the federal government did not move quickly enough. Credit where credit is due. The governor and the mayor of the city of New York, as well as the governor of New York, have moved swiftly to provide information on this issue and have moved to find more places to do the testing in the state of New York, including private facilities. We have been doing that and are doing that as quickly as possible, identifying new cases and determining where we should actually have people self-quarantine. So certainly, if you are sick, stay home. I know that one of my staffers we found out today that she was having some cold-like symptoms, and we said, stay at home. Don't even put the shoes on. Stay on. And that's you should try to do the same as much as possible. So we go forward again. Let's not panic. Make sure that we share good information with each other and keep track of what's happening back in our districts and our homes. Moving on. 17, first bill, 1798, my bill. And if it comes out of here, it will go to first reading.
This bill limits excessive price gouging on prescription drugs.
It is a series, there's a series of bills all having to do with price gouging. This one moved last year. We recognize how important it is to deal with high prescription prices. There's a couple of different strategies of how to do it. There might be some stuff in the One House that we are introducing soon, which will deal with this, but we wanted to make sure that we moved as many bills as possible since we know that it is a consistent problem. So this is why we moved this bill as well. Any questions or comments?
Move it.
All right, I have a motion from Senator Gallivan, second from Senator Metzger. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? And that bill moves to first reading. Second one, 1811A, thank you. If it moves from here, it will move to first reading.
This bill requires the Medicaid director to be appointed by the governor and confirmed by the Senate.
Pretty self-explanatory. It is important to have that extra layer, I believe, of accountability. So I know that I've tried to move this in the last couple of years. Hopefully we'll move this year. Do I have any questions or comments? Senator Metzger moves, second by Senator Gallivan. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? And that bill goes to first reading. Next bill by Senator Gorin, 2996A. If it moves from here, it will move to finance.
This bill establishes the Dominic Murray Sudden Cardiac Arrest Prevention Act.
named after the tragic death of a young man out in Long Island. It would establish that there would be, direct the health commissioner to develop information about sudden cardiac arrest, and is supported by quite a few folks. No questions or comments? Senator Kaminsky.
Move the bill.
Senator Kaminsky moves the bill. Senator Metzger seconds. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Move the bill moves to finance. Next, also would move to finance 3458A.
This bill allows Medicaid to cover medically tailored meals and medical nutrition therapy provided there is federal financial participation.
So we moved this last year. It's a recognition that particularly for those folks who are recovering, having a particular diet would be important in making sure that they not only recover but that they stay healthy. So we believe that this should be covered by Medicaid. We moved it last year to finance. Hopefully we can move it a little bit further this year. And I would note that we not only require federal participation, but also it actually outweighs whatever costs are outweighed by the savings that will be created by keeping people healthier for a longer period of time. Do I have any questions or comments? Do I have a motion? Thank you, Senator Hoyland. Senator Hoyland moves the bill. Seconded by Senator Metzger. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed?
Without rec
from Senator Gallivan. That bill moves to finance. Next, right on time, Senator Hoyland. Senator Hoyland's bill, 4310A.
This bill authorizes the presence of EpiPens on preschool premises.
Anything you'd want to say about the bill, Senator Hoyland?
Just that it would protect vulnerable kids from these types of anaphylactic reactions due to food or medical allergies or insect stings.
Any questions or comments? Senator Kaminsky moves the bill, seconded by Senator Metzger. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? And that bill moves to first reading, I believe? Yes, it moves to first reading. Next, Senator bill by Senator Sanders, Senate Bill 4649, it would move to first reading.
This bill adds dysmenorrhea as a covered condition for medical marijuana.
This is, we've done this a couple of times in the last few years. We've added conditions to the medical marijuana program, and this would add this painful condition to the conditions that would be covered for medical marijuana. Any questions or comments?
Comment?
Yes, Senator Gallivan.
I'll be without rec because it would be my belief that this would already be covered and not necessary under the chronic pain and suffering provision. Mm-hmm. But nonetheless, I'll be without rec for that reason.
Any other questions or comments? No. All right, Senator Metzger moves the bill, seconded by Senator Kaminsky. All those in favor? Aye. Nays? And without rec, Senator Gallivan. That bill moves to first reading. Next, Senate Bill 4930A by this dude.
This bill requires chain restaurants to label menu items that have a high sodium content.
Again, it would have an exclusion for two exclusions that are important to mention. One of them, if there is something that is already being done at the local level, this would not overstep that, but it would allow the locality to continue doing what it's doing, particularly since the city of New York is doing something similar. And there is, you would have to have 15 or more locations in the state. So obviously small businesses are excluded from this requirement. Do I have any questions or comments? Senator Gallivan.
Comment only, I'll be voting in the negative. While I appreciate the intent of this bill, sodium is an issue, and I think in this particular case, if it's an issue to the extent that we should be doing something about it, it should have application across the board.
Duly noted, Senator Gallivan. Any other questions or comments? Do I have a motion? Oh, Senator Holmes.
So I commend the sponsor for bringing this forward, and high sodium is the cause of a lot of incredibly difficult health conditions like hypertension, high blood pressure. And I think there'll be great cost savings in the bigger picture as we help consumers understand that they need to cut down on salt. So I move the bill.
Senator Holman moves the bill, seconded by Senator Metzger. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Without rec? Well, I oppose Senator Galvan. Without recs, that moves to first reading. Next, by Senator Savino, Senate Bill 5657B. And if it moves from here, it will go to finance.
This bill makes various amendments to the medical marijuana statute.
In particular, there's a whole host of amendments that really relate to expanding economic opportunity for folks who've been impacted by the war on drugs generally, and by the criminalization of marijuana in particular, both as it relates to people having being business owners as well as working within the field. So I am very supportive of this measure. I'm glad that the senator is moving it. Any questions or comments?
A comment. I'll be without rec. I supported the passage of medical marijuana. Obviously, research shows there's legitimate medicinal uses. I'm without rec solely because of the concern about smoking in general. However, I'm voting to move it along because ultimately, I think that decision, it's appropriate the decision is made between doctor and patient. But this committee has talked about the harms of smoking. Mm-hmm. And I think it'd be remiss if I just didn't point that out, that I have some concerns about the smoking part of it. Right. But I will be, nonetheless, I will be without rec.
Thank you, Senator. Any other questions or comments? Senator Metzger moves the bill, seconded by Senator Hellman. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? And without rec, Senator Gallivan. Next by me as well, Senate Bill 5762A.
This bill updates the Family Health Care Decision Act to include decisions for a patient in mental hygiene facilities.
So this is mostly in, it takes out some redundancies that are currently in state law back, I believe, 2010. Mm-hmm. In 2010, there was a bill that kind of took everything related to DNR orders and kind of consolidated it, and there's still pieces of it that need to be clarified and redundancies removed. So it won't change anything that is currently in state law. It would just remove a redundancy that currently exists in state law. And are there any questions or comments? Do I have a motion? Senator Holman moves the bill, seconded by Senator Metzger. All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Without rec? All right, that bill moves to first reading. And apparently everybody's just right on time, because next is Senator Benjamin's bill. Senator Holman waited outside until his bill was almost up, and then he came in. And you were right outside, but you waited, and now here he is, Senator Benjamin. So Senator Benjamin, Bill 6705.
This bill directs the Department of Health to develop educational information on bone marrow donation and registries, and to have primary care practitioners make the information available.
If it moves, it would move to first reading. Senator Benjamin, do you have anything to add on?
No.
All right. Any questions or comments? All right. Do I have a motion? Senator Biagi motions the bill. Second by Senator Kaminsky. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Without rec? And that bill moves to first reading. Moving right along. Now, Senator Metzger has been here the entire time, so she just didn't get here, but she's been here the whole time. Senate Bill 6813 by Senator Metzger, if it moves, it would move to first reading.
This bill requires food establishments to permit the use of reusable beverage and food containers provided by customers.
Any comments or questions from you, Senator Metzger?
Only that, this is really important to reducing single-use packaging and cups and plastics and the like, and it gives people the right to bring their own, and I think will encourage people to bring their own. I've been doing it for years, and pretty easy to do. So thank you for bringing it. We'll move.
Senator Gallagher.
A comment. I think this is a worthy discussion to have. But given what we've seen over the past week and the concern about the spreading of disease, I think that now is just inappropriate or imprudent to be doing this at this time. So I'll be voting against it.
I should say that it has, that the effective date is 1 year from its passage, well, from its signature. So it, I mean, certainly if we're talking about this a year from now, our concerns are going to be a lot bigger than whether we actually have coffee in our own little cup or what have you. But, you know, duly noted, you will still be voting in the negative?
Can I ask you a question? Yes. What is your concern?
I think it's, we're dealing with coronavirus now and the spreading of disease. I think we should get through that, and then it would be more appropriate to have a discussion about that, this particular bill.
But what is the thing that might happen that causes a concern? Like what, in other words, someone does something that results in someone getting sick?
Yes. If the way that I would understand it, you would bring in, whether it's your coffee cup or whether it's your food container that you'd be handling, and you have the potential for the worker at the restaurant to handle. And that could be the spreading of something back and forth. I'm not, all I'm simply saying is, at this time, because of what we're dealing with over the past month or so.
I appreciate it. So in other words, someone gives their virus coffee cup to the coffee shop worker.
Well, I'm not saying it's got virus in it, but I'm saying
it's something like that. Is now in contact with something that he or she wouldn't have been in contact with in a world.
Potentially, but I would just say that we don't know. I'm not able to articulate from a scientific position what diseases, viruses, what can be spread or what cannot be spread scientifically. I'm just simply thinking we have a lot of unknowns about this COVID-19. And we've got a whole host of people. We get people on the verge of panic. But I agree with the chair's point. I think our government has done a good job in trying to avert that and take precautions. So I'm just simply saying that while we're talking about this right now, I'm just simply saying that this, my opinion would be that this is a better conversation for a different day after we get through this.
Gotcha. Senator Biagi.
So, I actually have been reading about this. Right now, there's some guidance on not using the reusable cup at the moment. But for the long term, the reducing waste and reducing the amount of plastics is ultimately, I think, the thing that weighs in favor of that. So while I think that your logic is correct, especially right now, and if we are giving a cup or a spoon or whatever that we're reusing that is washed first or at least disinfected, I think for the long term, it's an important thing that we should be doing.
Oh, no. The point's extremely well made. My concern is just having that discussion now. It's getting out, get past this coronavirus, and then...
Right, but the discussion doesn't make it law. The discussion just makes it potentially become law. And even if it became law, it wouldn't really go into effect until after this entire issue.
It has a year effective date.
No, that point's well taken, and the point is also well taken that if we're dealing with coronavirus a year from now, we've got much bigger problems. We don't know when that will be over with. So I understand. I'm not talking about the merits of the bill itself, just simply the timing.
I think it's odd to consider legislation based on the timing of a single event. That's all. I understand.
But this is more than a single event. This is
I understand, but just generally, globally speaking, a law, it should be able to. You may have disagreements with it. If you have a disagreement with it as it applies now, I imagine you continue to have a disagreement with it going forward.
Well, no. We have, to Senator Biagi's point, and I forget, I've seen one or two national chains, I don't know if it was Starbucks or another, that they've essentially temporarily suspended being able to use your own program. So they have concerns about it now.
Okay.
But again, the concern is going to end. I'm only saying, right now, the unknowns about coronavirus, until we're out of the woods or past that, now is just not the time to be having the discussion about this, my thought. And let's just say it is a year out. My thought would be that hopefully we'll be well beyond this. If it passes it ultimately, no effect, no concern. That'd be the best scenario. But I just think, because we have an unknown, that this should just be on hold until we're past that unknown.
Senator Hoyman, do you want to chime in?
I was trying to come up with a New York clean joke. You know, the hand sanitizer.
I could have. Is there a supply here?
I'm sure there's like gallons of it floating in this building. There's some of us who are not going to get
He's not allowing members of the legislature.
No, certainly. Well, some members certainly not. And lest we forget, and this needs to be stated for the record, although it certainly is a solid idea to provide something so that we can get access to it in a quicker way, do remember that it is made with slave labor. It is made by people inside prisons who we pay less than, it's like 60 cents per hour to produce this thing. So one of the reasons it's so cheap is because we're producing it with slave labor. So let's not beat around the bush on that one. And now I'm even less getting
rid of it. Shall we vote on this bill?
We should vote.
My intention was not to open a motion.
There is a motion by Senator Benjamin.
Senator Hoyman's lead.
There is a second by Senator Biagi. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Opposed.
Without rec? Without rec, Senator Kaminsky. And that bill moves to first reading. Moving on to Senate Bill 7085 by Senator Ramos. If it moves from here, it would move to finance.
This bill requires cafeteria staff to be trained to prevent and respond to anaphylaxis with an EpiPen.
Right.
School cafeteria.
So to the school cafeteria folks. We have a motion from Senator Kaminsky, second from Senator Wellman. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Opposed.
Opposed, Senator Gallivan, without rec. And that bill moves to finance. Next, Bill 7812 by me would move to finance if it moves from here.
This bill protects the choice of school-based health clinics to participate in Medicaid managed care.
We have been for the last couple of years, there's some populations that as we move to managed care, we've kept in fee-for-service. School-based health centers are one of them. We want to make sure that that can continue to happen. We want to give them the choice to transfer to transition to managed care. If necessary, this bill would make that possible. Any questions or comments? Do I have a motion? Motion from Senator Kaminsky, seconded by, I saw you scratching, Senator Benjamin, you did it. You seconded the motion. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Without rec? And that bill goes to finance. Last but certainly not least, Senate Bill 7828 by Senator Breslin.
This bill requires licensure for pharmacy benefit managers and specifies their duties and obligations as service providers.
So while this bill makes some clarifying amendments, it is mostly the same bill that was vetoed last year. Many of us feel that it is incredibly important to regulate and provide transparency for pharmacy benefit managers. This bill would do that, and I'm hoping that we can actually get it, maybe something in budget, but something to regulate pharmacy benefit managers in this state this year would be essential. Do I have any questions or comments? Senator Gallivan.
Comment. I'll be voting in the negative. I do believe that oversight of PBMs is warranted. I think this bill, though, is onerous and goes too far to the extent that it may ultimately have the opposite effect, that the cost of compliance would ultimately raise the cost of prescription drugs. But nonetheless, your first point is very well taken. There does need to be some level of oversight.
All right. Any other questions or comments? Do I have a motion?
Second.
Senator Biagi motions, Senator Kaminsky seconds. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Senator Gallivan, without rec. And that bill moves to first reading, and we are done for the day. Be safe, folks.